Anduril Industries has revealed its Barracuda family of cruise missiles. The weapons are already in flight test, and sensors will be added as per requirements. The family of weapons comprises the Barracuda 100, 250, and 500. The missile series has been designed to be a low-cost weapon, as well as can be rapidly produced with uncomplicated processes. The Barracuda family is powered by Anduril's Lattice for Mission Autonomy software, allowing for autonomous and collaborative behaviors that are critical in contested environments. In this video, Defense Updates reports how the Barracuda series of missiles help the U.S. military in future conflicts. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Anduril said all versions of the Barracuda would be able to fly at speeds of up to 575 miles per hour or 925 kilometers per hour. The smallest version, the Barracuda 100, would have a range of up to 85 miles or 135 kilometers when launched in the air and carry a payload of up to 35 pounds or about 16 kilograms. It could be launched from the ground, from the tail of a C-130 mobility aircraft, or from the rails of AH-64 Apache or AH-1Z Viper helicopters. The Barracuda 250 would be able to fly about 230 miles or 370 kilometers when air-launched, though its payload capacity would be the same as the 100. It could be launched from the internal weapons bay of F-35 fighters or bombers and externally from F-15E Strike Eagles, F-16 Fighting Falcons, and F-18E and F Super Hornets. The Barracuda 500 could have a range of more than 575 miles or 925 kilometers, carry more than 100 pounds or 45 kilograms of payload, and loiter for more than 2 hours. Besides being launched externally from the F-15E, F-16, and F-18E and F, Anduril said it could be launched as a palletized munition. This refers to the U.S. Air Force's Rapid Dragon concept of launching pallets of cruise missiles from the back of a C-17 or C-130 transport, which has been tested using AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missiles, JASSMs. Anduril also said Barracuda missiles are highly maneuverable and able to withstand up to 5G forces. The Barracuda family is intended to be rapidly upgradable through software and an open system architecture. As per Chris Brose, Anduril's chief strategy officer, Anduril is testing Barracuda as part of the Air Force Armament Directorate and Defense Innovation Unit's Enterprise Test Vehicle (ETA) project, among other testing programs he declined to specify. ETV seeks to test prototypes as a modular drone to test payloads, sensors, and other technology and be produced affordably at high rates. Diem Salmon, Anduril's vice president for Air Dominance and Strike, noted that all three versions have conducted flight tests. Anduril is also focused on testing its subsystems, particularly its flight software, she said, to make sure we're wringing out all the kinks there. Anduril touched upon the fact that the Barracuda series will be flexible by stating all Barracudas are compatible with a host of payloads and employment mechanisms, support a variety of different missions, and provide warfighters with an adaptable and upgradable capability to counter evolving threats. The company also said in press materials, a single Barracuda takes 50% less time to produce, requires 95% fewer tools, and 50% fewer parts than competing solutions on the market today. As a result, the Barracuda family of AAVs is 30% cheaper on average than other solutions, enabling affordable mass and cost-effective large-scale employment. DM Salmon noted, rather than designing bespoke capabilities for each single weapon system that you're trying to put out there, how do we actually make this simpler and how do we actually design out the hard parts? Anduril also created a hyperscale production strategy for Barracuda based on a simple design with fewer parts that uses commercial components and requires no more than 10 tools to assemble, the company said. Besides bringing down costs, Salmon said Anduril's approach to Barracuda will allow the company to scale production up or down as needed. Viewers may note that Anduril Industries is one of the two companies selected by the U.S. Air Force to develop the first increment of collaborative combat aircraft. In recent weeks, Anduril unveiled its new arsenal manufacturing plant concept, hinting at upcoming announcements about advanced weapons like the Barracuda and its Fury collaborative combat aircraft, which will be produced in the state-of-the-art facility. The war in Ukraine has shown that in a high-end conflict, weapons will get expended very quickly. Both Ukraine and Russia are struggling to cope with the consumption rate of precision-guided munitions. This is where the Barracuda series comes in. Anduril Chief Strategy Officer Chris Brose pointed to this. The problem that we're seeking to solve here, I think, is a familiar one to many of you, which is America and our allies and partners do not have enough weapons, period, full stop. And we're not capable of producing the volume of weapons that we're going to need to establish deterrence against a peer competitor. The assessment is in line with what CSIS, or the Center for Strategic and International Studies, had stated earlier. CSIS had noted that in a major regional conflict, such as a war with China in the Taiwan Strait, the U.S. use of munitions would likely exceed the current stockpiles of the U.S. Department of Defense, DOD. According to the results of a series of CSIS war games, the United States would likely run out of some munitions, such as long-range, precision-guided munitions, in less than a week. Barracuda series could help with this kind of situation. Designed for flexibility, affordability, and scalability, Barracuda could redefine how the U.S. military approaches conflicts in the 21st century.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.